it is so good to see you today. We have a lot in store.
So much in store for you. It's gonna be a fun time here at church.
Yeah, and we're gonna get started with our values.
It's time for values?
Yeah, it's time for values.
Oh boy, it's the values game show.
Oh, okay. We're on a game show now. Here we go.
It's a game show today.
All right.
And we're gonna have our favorite contestant, Alexis, here, talk about the values.
Yes.
All right. Alexis, the very first question for 300 potatoes. What is the first value?
Love God.
Is it love God? It's love God. Okay. That's correct, Lexi. Now, Alexis, what is the heart behind that value? It's so very important, but I need to make sure that you know it for sure.
I think we love God because God is love, and he first loved us.
That's right. All your potatoes will be baked or boiled.
Yes.
Sent straight to you. Alrighty. Well, our second value is also very, very important. And that value goes for 200 apples. What is it?
Ooh, that's a lot of apples. Love people.
Love people. That's correct.
Yes.
Great job, Lexi.
Thanks.
Man, I'm so proud of you. Wow. All right. And we love people because God loves all people. Lexi, does God love you?
Yeah, he loves me and he loves you and he loves you.
And he loves me. God loves all people. All right. Time for our third value. Our third value is for 1,000 paper clips.
1,000 paper clips?
That's a lot of paper clips.
Yeah.
What is our third value, Alexis?
Do your best.
That's right, do your best. You're gonna have to do your best to keep track of all those paper clips.
Yeah, now I have 1,000 paper clips.
You have 1,000 paper clips. And what happens when you do your best, Lexi?
Ooh, I know, God does the rest.
God does the rest. Now you have 1,000 things to put in those paper clips.
Yeah, I guess I do.
Now, for our fourth and final value for 50 pairs of left socks. What's our fourth value, Alexis?
Left socks? What about the right ones?
They're still in the wash.
Okay, well, the fourth value is to have fun.
That's right, have fun. And now, for the 50 other socks, what is the second part of the fourth value?
Because God gives us joy.
That's right. Great, great job, everyone. Lexi, you did a great job today at the values, and so did you guys. We're all values winners. Look at that.
Look at that.
Now, it's time for worship. So everyone, let's stand up on our feet and get ready to worship God.
All right, you guys, let's stand up on our feet. Let's get ready to worship. Let's sing it out. The Chosen One.
He's the Chosen One. He's the champion. The winner for all time. With me to the end. Jesus is my friend. He's always by my side. Anything I face, he will be my strength.
Shout it out.
Shout it out. It's not over. I am more.
out. There is joy. Let's clap those hands.
Sing to the Lord.
I've searched the world for a love that could fill my heart. Nothing compares to the wonder of who you are. Holy, all the earth singing holy, all the angels cry holy.
job, everyone. Let's keep worshiping God. Give him all that you have. He is the Lord. Sing out. Sing out to him. Sing worthy. Come on, lift your voice. Give him all that you have. Great job worshiping everyone. All right, let's all bow our heads and close our eyes, and we're going to pray. Thank you, Jesus, that we get to join with the angels, with all the heavens, and sing, worthy are you. You are worthy, Lord Jesus. We love you and we praise you today in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Great job, everybody.
Hi, everyone. It's time for our scripture memory verse, so I need everyone to get up on your feet. Now the first time, I'll say it. The second time, you'll repeat it after me. And the third time, we'll all say it together. If you've got it, give me two thumbs up. All right, guys, now the first time, you'll just watch me. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. Romans 12, 10 through 11. Now the second time, you'll repeat it after me. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. Romans 12, 10 through 11. All right, everyone, now this last time, we'll all say it together. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. Romans 12, 10 through 11. Great job, everyone. Keep working on that verse, and we'll see you next time.
I love a good memory verse. Thanks for sharing that with us, Alexis.
Yeah, of course. And that brings us to the next part of our service, which is...
Main point!
Yeah, our main point for the day is good friends help one another.
That's right. Wait, isn't it?
Yeah.
Alexis, can you help me? I think you're a good friend.
Of course I can.
I have a lot to do.
Okay.
I have dishes, I have homework, I need to clean the windows, I need to mow the lawn. I have a garden I'm kind of working on, but I really need a lot of help.
Najee, that's a lot.
Yeah.
I can't help you, but maybe let's circle back on that. We're actually going to talk about helping our friends today in the service.
Sure, I'll bring it back up later.
Okay, so Jay is going to catch us up on what's happening in Paul's life. So last week, we were talking about Paul's conversion. So let's see what Jay's going to tell us today.
What's up? It's Jay here, and I'm super excited that you're watching the show today. It means a whole lot to me, and it shows me a couple things. One, that you want to learn more, and two, and most importantly, that you love to have fun. So let's go! But really, I'm so excited for today. And you might ask, why are you so excited, Jay? Well, let me tell you, because it's another day where I get to reach out to one of my friends and ask them how things are going and learn something together. And guess what? You're right here with me to be a part of it. How cool is that? But as I said before, relationships are so important. Matter of fact, we are made for relationships. That's right. God wired us to be in relationships because it's a part of our identity. And best of all, He wants to be best friends with you. Isn't that awesome? So on that note, does anybody remember what we talked about last time with my friend January? If you haven't watched it, it's okay. But she taught me about this incredible guy in the Bible named Paul. I'm sure you've heard of him before. Not only did he write 13 books of the Bible, but his letters are so relevant today. And aside from Jesus, he is probably the most influential person of preaching God's word. Last time we covered his upbringing and how Paul's encounter with Jesus completely turned his life upside down. He went from someone who was persecuting Christians, like he was literally hunting Christians because he thought they were a threat, to becoming someone who started to follow Jesus with his whole heart and completely dedicated his life to him. And today I want to pick up right there, right where Paul finally made it to Damascus. But he was dependent on the help from some of his amazing friends in order to succeed and spread God's good news. What a guy. But before we get there, I couldn't help myself. I was watching a bunch of funny videos again today, and I want to show you some of my favorites. Let's take a look at them.
Catch.
All right, let's get to it. Let me call a very special friend today. I'm super pumped. Ooh. I hope he answers. This would be great. This would be real awkward if he don't answer. He usually answers. This would be good. Yo!
Yo, what's up, JJJ!
What's going on, man? What you got? What you doing?
Just hanging out. I'll tell you, man, I'm doing good. Been doing good, but I'm doing a lot better now that you called, man. How you been?
I've been good, man. You know, same old, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I mean, you know how I do. But I am starting this new thing where I want to, you know, connect with my friends more and be more intentional. And so I decided to call you today.
Yeah.
Now, hey, I mean, man. I did call January last week, but I'm calling you today because you're my dog.
Hey, real quick. Just let me ask a question.
Okay, go ahead.
You called January 1st before me?
I did. I mean, I did, but I called you now.
Yeah. But I'm your boy. Hey, for real though, man.
You got me, man. It's so cool
how you're going through a hard time, you're going through a good time, whatever it is, but you get to call and catch up with a friend. Like, that means the world.
Yeah, because, I mean, it can be tough sometimes to be intentional with my friends and catch up. So, you know, I'm just trying to do my part to catch up with you and see what's going on.
Well, man, it's on me, too. I could do better. But, hey, look, how's January doing? I know you chatted with her.
January's great. Like, we had a great time last week. We learned together. She actually taught me about this really cool guy named the Apostle Paul, who did so much, you know?
Yeah, Paul is the man.
Yeah, Paul is the man. And she opened my eyes to, you know, just all the things that Paul did and how great it is that Jesus can save each and every one of us, just like he did Paul.
It's crazy, man. Like, no matter where you're from or what you've been through, God can change your life. And Paul's story is an amazing depiction of that.
And I'm super grateful for that. So I got an idea. How about we pick up right there and learn more about Paul's story?
That sounds awesome. Let's do it.
Great. Now, I have this video for you. But first, let me catch you up just a little bit. We're going to start right on the road to Damascus, right after Paul's conversion. And he's trying to go all in with Jesus. But it's just not as smooth of a start as he thinks it's going to be. And we're going to see what happens in there. You ready?
Let's do it.
Cool. Let's check it out.
This is Paul. Paul's life just got turned upside down. He was a Pharisee who was trying to please God in every way ever since he was a little boy. He gave everything to follow God's laws and commands. So when a new idea or something came up that was against his custom, he got pretty upset, even to the point of hurting others. At the time, Paul didn't accept Christians and thought they were a threat to God. But what he didn't realize is that he was actually fighting against the same God he was trying to please. Yet an encounter with Jesus himself changed everything. From that point on, Paul turned his life around and started following Jesus with his whole heart. All of this happened quite drastically while Paul was on his way to Damascus. The Christians were afraid of him because they thought he was coming to hurt them. But instead, he began to preach the good news in that city. More and more crowds were gathering to hear what he had to say. That made some of the Pharisees very angry. They had the same mindset that Paul used to have. But now, they thought that Paul was the dangerous one threatening their faith. So they started to look for a way to kill him. But Paul was always one step ahead and found out their plans. His enemies watched the city gates day and night, determined to catch him when he tried to leave Damascus. Paul and his friends had other plans, and God wanted Paul to survive so he could tell everyone about Jesus in other cities as well. This was their plan. They got a large basket, large enough to hold a man. They tied ropes onto the basket and lowered it down to the ground on the inside of the city walls. When it was dark, Paul got into the basket, and his friends raised him up, put him through an opening in the wall, and lowered him down to the other side. He didn't use the city gates at all. His enemies' plans were destroyed, and Paul left the city in safety. He went from Damascus to Jerusalem, but the Christians there were afraid of him also. A good man named Barnabas stood up for Paul and told the Christians that he really had changed. They were encouraged, and Paul was accepted by them and preached all over Jerusalem. But it became dangerous there also when the Jews from Greece tried to kill him. He fled from one place to another, escaping the enemy, and next his friends took him to Caesarea, and then sent him off to Tarsus, his hometown. Paul had some incredible friends, friends like Barnabas, who stuck with him when things became difficult. Barnabas was so faithful to Paul and hung out with him even though it was quite dangerous. This story shows us that good friends are always encouraging, that they stand up for each other, and that they help each other no matter what.
Close. Not only once, but twice?
Yeah, man. It was heated everywhere he went.
Yeah, it's crazy how quickly the tables turned on him, you know? Like, he just wanted to preach the good news of Jesus. And he went from being the persecutor to persecuted.
Yeah, I mean, that's wild. But what was more amazing is, you know, the amazing friends he had to help him through these tough times.
Yeah, he had some really, really quality friends.
He really did. And it gives me an idea, man, about what our main point should be today.
All right, what you got?
Good friends help one another.
I like it, man. Straightforward, to the point.
Yeah, simple. But it shows us that we all can be better friends by helping each other out. But we can talk about that a little later. But for now, it's game time!
Oh, all right, hold on, hold on.
Where'd you go, bro? Come back.
No.
Making shark noises.
Game time is my middle name.
Your middle name is not Game Time. I think it might be Bruce. Bruce.
No, Game Time is like a saying. Like it's my middle name. Like it's a my middle name is actually
whatever you say, man. But yeah. January showed me this really cool game, you know, of how we can remember what we learned. So we're gonna play a little game of trivia. You
okay. Ready for trivia? What's the game? Let's do it.
Do you like trivia?
Duh.
Well, let's get to it. You ready for the first question?
Yes.
All right. You ready for the first question? Great. All right. So, first question. How did Paul escape Damascus?
That was pretty slick, actually. So, his friends lowered him in a basket through the city walls. It was cool.
Oh, sounds cool. Ding, 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 ding. You are correct.
Hey, do you know what that sound is? That's the sound of victory.
That's awesome.
All right, let's go.
All right, you ready for question two?
Okay.
All right, question number two.
Okay.
Where did Paul preach the gospel next?
Left. So if the sun rises
Hey, bro, that has nothing to do with, like, your sense of direction has nothing to do with the question. It's not like you were actually there.
I guess you're right. Okay, I don't know that answer.
It's Jerusalem.
Oh, Jerusalem. That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
Stay with me. Jerusalem. There you go. Say it again one more time.
Jerusalem.
There you go. You got it.
Okay. All right.
You ready for question three?
Come on.
All right. So who stood up for Paul and told the Christians that he had really changed?
Oh, that's Barabbas. Yeah.
Close. Very close. Barabbas was the guy, you remember, you know, that was with Jesus, and, you know, the crowd chose Barabbas to be saved instead of Jesus. You remember?
Yeah. I meant Barnabas, not Barabbas.
Barnabas! That's right. Good job, bro. Barnabas is right.
Thank you. Pat on the back.
Hey, proud of you. You did good.
Thank you, dude. Thank you. Hey, that was a lot of fun, but let me ask you a question now. Can I do that?
Okay. I guess you can ask me a question.
What do you think that we can learn from this story today?
You know, man, I think the most important thing we can learn is how Paul needed godly friends. He needed great friends to help him to be able to spread the gospel like he did. He couldn't do it without his friends. So all of us need friends just like that.
Yeah. Well, dude, I'm glad that you are a friend of mine. Like, you mean the world to me. And this story helps us to be better friends. A friend who protects, who stands up for others, who lifts others up, you know?
Yeah, I mean, Paul gets a lot of accolades. And, you know, he deserves it because he's so amazing. But where would Paul be without friends like Barnabas? Like, he wouldn't be able to spread the gospel to all the people that he did without friends helping him.
I think that is exactly right, man. It's so cool how God will put people in your life for a purpose. And, like, we have these plans for our lives, and we actually can't do them without the people around us. So God uses those people to help fulfill his plans. It's awesome.
That's so good, man. And that reminds me of an awesome clip. Let's check out our friend Alexis and see how she explains how important it is to have good friends. Let's check it out.
Hi, everyone. My name is Alexis with today's object lesson, and I have a question for you. Would you rather have one stuffed animal or two stuffed animals? Would you rather have one cookie or two cookies? I say two, one for me and one for you. Would you rather have 1 hour of homework or 2 hours of homework? Wait, I don't think I want 2 hours of homework. Okay, we'll leave that question be. But did you know that in the Bible, there's a place that tells us that two are better than one? It's found in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. It says, two are better than one because they have a good reward for their toil or their work. For if they fall, one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him who is alone when he falls and has not another to lift him up. Today's main point is good friends can help one another. Now, I know someone in the Bible who was a really good friend, and his name was Barnabas. He was a great friend to a man named Saul. When Saul first became a Christian, people were a little unsure that he had really changed, but Barnabas stuck by his side and was such a help to him. Now, I have another question. Now, answer wisely with this one. Would you rather have one piece of spaghetti or two pieces of spaghetti? I know, kind of random. We're talking about spaghetti, but we have to make a choice, one or two. I say, let's start with one and let's see what happens. This piece of spaghetti is going to represent us, and we are going to be tasked with lifting up a weight to see if we can do it alone or if we can't. All right, so I'm gonna set up my fancy pillars here, and I'm gonna set us in the middle. All right, that looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna take this cup, and I'm going to fill it with some weight. I got some magnets from my fridge. That'll work just fine. All right, and I'm gonna take this paper clip, and I'm gonna hook it right here. And now let's see if this one strand can hold this weight. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Okay, definitely not. So let's move to the two pieces and see what happens. So I have two pieces here that I've tied together with a little rubber band so that they wouldn't roll away from each other. And let's reset this. So we've got the same weight, same paperclip, same cup. And let's see what happens. All right. Look at that. It bends a little bit, but it is definitely holding up the weight. In this case, two, definitely better than one. Now, just for fun, what if we had a bunch of friends helping us out? Let's see. Bum-ba-dum. All right, so this is gonna represent a bunch of friends. We're not alone in this. We can lift up this heavy weight. Let's see what happens. Look at that, it doesn't even bend. Pretty cool. So let's remember today that good friends can help one another. Maybe not just physically lift something heavy, but know that good friends can help others in different ways. Maybe you can encourage a friend, or maybe you can lift them up by telling them the truth about who they really are. You know, good friends are a great help. So let's remember today's main point and let's put it into practice this week. Good friends can help one another.
So good, Alexis. Thank you.
Yeah, it was so great. And Alexis helped me understand it so much more. And it made me realize that I'm so grateful that you're my friend. And my life's so much better because you are, bro.
Dude, I feel the same way. Let me tell you, man. It meant the world to me you called me today. So thank you for that.
I appreciate you answering, man. Like, you didn't have to do that. You were doing things all day. And, like, you answered my phone call. And I appreciate it. And I want you to know that if you ever need anything, I mean anything that you need help with, I'm here for you.
Hey, deal. Same goes for you, man. I got your back.
Awesome, man. I'm going to let you go. Do whatever you got to do the rest of the day. It's going to be great. You're going to have a great day. And I appreciate you talking to me today.
All right, dog. I'll see you soon.
Bye, bro. Man, my guy. Jeremy's such a good dude. That was so good, wasn't it? I mean, all it took was a simple phone call and an amazing conversation like that happened. It was so easy. And I hope you had just as much fun as I did, but I want you to remember our main point for today. Good friends help one another. And you can be such a helpful friend. I mean, your friend's life is probably not in danger, but he or she may just need some encouragement. Whatever your friend is going through right now, some encouraging and uplifting words can be super important. Your friends may need to know that you are there for them in good times and especially in the bad times. And let's be honest, it doesn't take much to say something nice, does it? So I want to leave you with this challenge, just a little challenge. And I know you like challenges. I want you to think about a friend to who you may haven't talked to in a while, or someone who needs a little encouragement. Whatever it may be, I want you to call him or her and just say how much you appreciate them, or maybe that you miss them. Maybe it's exactly what they need to hear today. And you'll see, it'll make not only their day, but your day so much better as well. Doesn't that sound good? Awesome. I can't wait for you to try to be a friend just like Barnabas. And on that note, that's pretty much all I got for you today. Hope you had a good time, and I hope this added so much more value to your life. Bye now, and we'll see you next time.
That was such an awesome video.
Yeah, it really was.
I learned a whole lot about being a good friend.
Yeah, Barnabas was such a good friend to Paul. I want to be a good friend like that.
Yeah, there's lots of ways to be a good friend. You could write your friend a letter.
Ooh, letters are really good.
Or you could call them.
I love calls.
Or, ooh, this could be fun. You could bake them some cookies and drop them off at their house.
Cookies! That's such a sweet way to tell your friends that you care. That's so important right now.
It really is. You know, it's great to have good friends, and it's great to be a good friend. And you know who's the best friend?
Oh, I know who's my best friend.
Jesus!
Jesus!
And he wants to be yours. You just have to ask him into your heart.
That's great. All you have to do is welcome Jesus into your heart.
That's right. And now we're going to have a template up on the screen that's similar to a prayer that Paul prayed in the Bible.
What? A prayer like Paul's? That'd be so cool to pray.
Well, you guys can pray that at home with your friends or family or whoever you're with. We hope you had a great time today in this service. We sure enjoyed seeing you guys and having you with us. We hope to see you next time. Bye.
Bye.